gentlemen. I'm very honored to tell you something about Huis van Hilde. But before I do that, I'd like to tell you something about myself. As I said, I am archaeologist. I worked in the fieldwork, as we looked just at all those fieldwork, for 15 years. And for 3 years now, I'm working as museum manager in an archaeological museum in the Netherlands, in Castricum, but it's nearby Amsterdam in the province of North Holland. My experience was that when I was digging on the site, there was public, there were volunteers, and they all went, wow, what a nice work you have, and what a nice finds, and what a beautiful story you tell about the history of our village. And then the fieldwork was over, the excavation was clear, and I was going to the office. And then my friends went with me, and after I read, I had a report written. The objects were boxed, and they go to the depository.
They disappear.
And then I read a nice report, and there are 15 or 20 of them, and maybe you Timo, you have read some of them, but I don't think other people do that. And that's for me as archaeologist, I found it very not nice that I can't share with public what story we want to tell, and that's the reason why we do this job, I think. So when in 2014 there was a new project of a new depository in the province of North Holland, and they thought it was nice to do something, in as stated in Article 9 of the Treaty of Malta, to do something for the public. And only the government is responsible for the depository, not for the public activities, and there I come in. So I found a very nice initiative to work there. Then Huis van Hilde wishes to expand the knowledge and of and support for the past through sharing of archaeological and historical knowledge. The exhibition is centered around 16 people, human figures with facial reconstructions, you see here, and from all periods of North Holland's history, from the early prehistory to the Second World War. The daily operations are run by volunteers, and in total there are 5 permanent employees, as of myself, and 100 volunteers. So, here we have a look. So, who are these people? Who is this lady? She is Hilde. She is found in Castricum. And what is her story? She's standing there with her arm, she's holding her arm. She is from the late Roman period. She died in Castricum. And we can't determine the cause of death from the bones. She appears to have died at the age of 35, and more or less in a healthy condition. She had a broken arm, and she originally brought up in Germany, so she's not from the Netherlands. And we know how she looked like, because we reconstructed the bones. So apart from Hilde, there are 16 super realistic human figures with replicas of clothing, weapons, jewelry, and the actual finds, the skeletons and the artifacts that people use are combined. And together with the human figures, they illustrate the story about the people of the past. But who is she? And who are these people? These are not people who did the archaeological digs. Most of them didn't visit an archaeological site. Most of them haven't a historical or archaeological background. Some of them aren't really interested in the objects. But all of them like the stories you tell. They like to tell their own story and like to listen to the others. And so does the public. We see when our nearest public, our ambassadors, our volunteers acknowledge the message of the stories which we are telling, then our public is enthusiastic and they listen and come back to us. As I saw in the other presentation, the volunteers are in range of age. Our volunteers are mostly 50 or 60 years old, but our youngest is 16 years old. So that's very nice. That's one or two, and then they can grow old. Yeah. And she, why is she doing this work? Why is she works in, I know everything about Ineke, so that's Ineke. She is a mother of two sons, she has, likes to run, I know everything. And she's enthusiastic, nice word it is. She likes the work because she can tell her story and she is, she likes to do it. And she is now a voluntary coordinator of the back office. Because we involve public, the audience, the volunteers, and also the people who at first sight didn't care about their history in our work, but they become the ambassadors of archaeology. They learn through archaeology. Now, I brought you these pictures as an example of how we try to let our audience meet the people of the past and try to tell them their story. Once a year, we celebrate Hilde's anniversary. And Huis van Hilde is an inside museum, but then we use the square before to make it work. And on this day, the volunteers are really doing everything to tell the public the stories about the past. The knowledge of the past is crucial for the identity and well-being of the inhabitants and also for the touristic development. And we also have an archaeological hotspot. We here we are with material from Amsterdam. There was our first project, and we see the children are very interested in the things, and not only children but also the adults like it. And at this moment we are working from a great from the repository. We got material from a castle in Egmond. So that's very nice to work with them in with their own history. So Hilde's home is not just a museum or a repository of archaeological finds, it's a place where the public and the volunteers can interact with their own history. And this interaction is possible because the volunteers are enjoying doing it. So what's in it for the volunteers? We provide lectures. We don't want to tell them fairy tales, so they have to be writing what they are telling to the public. And we give trainees. There are also first aid. And they really like to be involved in these projects, feasts and so on. And we foremost try to facilitate their activities so they can enjoy what they are doing best. And but they have a list. We have a list. They have a contract with us. And it's my job to make them at ease. At home. I think we want to present our ancestors not as primitive ape-like barbarians, but as healthy, well-fed, sophisticated people as they were. They had complicated social structures and rituals just as our employees and volunteers. And I think that's also very important, that voluntary work may be voluntary, but not without obligations. And I thank you for that attention.